Welcome to hardhatengineer.com. I am Varun Patel. In this video, you will learn about symbols and legends used in PFD and P&ID. PFD and P&ID are also known as PFS and PEFS. PFD is process flow diagram. P&ID is process or piping and instrument diagram. PFS means process flow schemes, and PFS means process engineering flow scheme. If you want to learn how to read P&ID and PFD, you must know the legend used in this drawing. So please watch the video till the end. You can download this presentation for free. The link is given in the description. Please subscribe to my channel because it helps me to increase my reach on YouTube, and you will also get regular updates on new video. So please subscribe. In this video, I have tried to cover symbols that regularly use on P&ID and PFD. There are other symbols also. You can check the full list of the symbol by visiting the link given in the description. I advise you, before you start working in an actual plant or a construction project, you should check the project specific symbol library, which is also known as P&ID lead sheets or P&ID legend drawing. P&ID symbols and level of information available on P&ID may change from company to company, but more or less they provide similar information. What is P&ID or PFD symbol is? P&ID symbols are graphical representation of physical equipment that install on field. There are few ISO and British standards available that provide symbols and best practice to draw PFD and P&ID, such as ISA S5.1, BS5070 and ISO 10628. Here you can see the symbols for a various type of rotary equipment such as centrifugal pump, vacuum pump and also positive displacement pump such as gear and screw type. Last two symbols are of vertical pump and turbine. In this slide, you can see the symbols for various type of compressor such as reciprocating, centrifugal, rotary, liquid ring and turbine driven. These are the symbols for heat exchanger. On a drawing, you can see both type of symbols are used. The one on the right hand side are more frequent than the one on the left hand side. Static equipments are straightforward: vessel, drum, tanks and furnace. Here you can see the symbols for dome roof tank, fixed roof tank and internal floating roof tank. In case the tank is only floating roof, then there will be no roof on this symbol. There are two type of tower are shown here. One with column internal and the other is without internal. There are different types of internal are used in the column, and for that different symbols are used. Here on this slide, you can see the different type of internal such as mist mat, pipe distributor, liquid spray distributor and trays. Here on the bottom part of the column, you can see the vortex breaker, baffle plate, packing bed and some other type of trays. This is how various lines and connections are shown on PFD and P&ID. Main process line are shown as a dark black line, whereas minor lines are shown as a thin black lines. You can see the symbols for pneumatic, hydraulic and capillary line also. Electric signals are shown as a dotted line and electromagnetic signal are shown as a wave on the solid line. This is the trickiest part of reading P&ID and PFD. Here you can see the various type of wall symbols. Now you are wondering what is tricky in this. Have a look on this for a while. In next slide, you will realize why. Okay, now look on this slide. Yes, these are all the symbols for the wall. Some of them are same, but many are different. If you remember that I have mentioned that P&ID symbols varies from company to company. Wall symbols are the one that change most of the time. So if you are moving from one company to other, don't rely on your memory and refer the lead sheets for the symbols. Lead sheets are the one that contains all the project or plant specific symbols. If you want to become an expert in wall and their functions, you can buy my full course on the wall, in which I have covered more than 18 types of wall. Yes, this is selling because that is how I pay the bill to produce the good quality videos. So please support by purchasing my course. The links are given in the description. Now back to our symbols. Here you can see the various instrument bubble. In a process plant, more than 90% of the instrument measures either pressure, temperature, flow or level. You can see the small table on the right hand side, which shows the first letter of the instrument. Now the function of these instruments are either indicate, record, control or transmit the measured value. Here on this table, you can see the meaning of first letter and subsequent letters. You can hold the video to read all the letters and their meaning. In next slide, I will tell you the meaning of the horizontal line on the instrument bubble. If there is a single horizontal line, that means the instrument is located on the main control panel and accessible to the panel operator. No horizontal line means the instrument is installed in the field near to the process and it is accessible to field operator. If there is a double horizontal line, that means the instrument is installed on some secondary satellite local panel in the field. The last type is the instrument bubble with single dash horizontal line. This symbol is used for the instrument that are inaccessible in the field or hidden or password protected on the control system. This is all about symbols used in PFS and PFS. With this knowledge, you are now ready to read P&ID and PFD. In next video, I will explain you how to read PFD and after that P&ID. Visit my website hardhatengineer.com to download this presentation and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to get regular updates on new video. Please like and share my video with your friends. If you want to request a video, write in the comment. See you soon. Goodbye. Take care.